Namaste.
I am so glad today to address you on the topic of granting permission for surgery in Ayurveda. More precisely, postgraduate surgeons in Ayurveda. I am so happy because not that the sudden ability for the Ayurveda doctors to practice surgery. Not on that at all. It's a matter of symbol. It's a matter of pride. It's a matter of, the right eligibility criteria being accepted by the government of India or the Ayurvedic Council in the Union government. I'm so glad that the medical science, Ayurveda, the ancient Indian science, was the mainstream medicine in India centenaries ago, which were actually harvesting all the newcoming or the then latest technologies being adopted every centenaries. Only these few couple of years or maybe 6 to 7 centuries, we have been trailing much behind in the matter of development in Ayurveda. Development in the sense, every century, every acharya has come and add up things to the science with how the science was grown all these centenaries. Now, for the past 6-7 centuries, that growth is totally nil. Now, in the post-independent India, after about 70 years of independence to our country, 70 years of independence to our science, Ayurveda has again been enabled or enriched with sanctioning proper enrollments to its Shastra from other sciences like physics and chemistry. We all know that modern medicine, the term modern medicine, it always derives its techniques, its ideologies from physics and chemistry. Similar way, Ayurveda has also the right to adopt whatever necessary from time to time in order to modernize our practice and modernize our science. But truly speaking, this is not going to change the fundamentals and the principles in Ayurvedic science like what we see in modern science. Every 10 years, we witness lot of changes in the principles and the pattern of medications in modern medicine, which is not at all seen in Ayurveda. So I am happy that the doctors which practice surgery during their tenure in the college, in the post-graduation, they should be allowed for practicing surgery in their career and also to teach to the next generations to come. So the accessory medications, the necessary anesthetic drugs, anesthetic science, anesthetology, everything should be taught to Ayurveda in order to develop its growth, which was halted for almost 6 to 7 centuries. Thank you so much. Namaste.